took him.
Yes.
As we were told in Genesis 5, 21 to 24, what did the first humans do? Or how did they forsake their walk with God and choose to walk with Satan? In Genesis 6, 11 and 12, the earth also was corrupt before God. And the earth was filled with violence. And God looked upon the earth, and behold, it was corrupt, for all flesh had corrupted his way upon the earth. These were all the wicked deeds that God saw before he decided to destroy the whole world with flood. What we have in the world today, the same act of wickedness in almost every strata of the society, which Apostle Paul saw among the early Christian believers, as we read in 1 Corinthians 6, 9 to 10. Or do you not know that the unrighteous will not inherit the kingdom of God? Do not be deceived, neither fornicators, nor idolaters, nor adulterers, nor effeminate, nor homosexuals, nor thieves, nor the covetous, nor drunkards, nor revilers, nor swindlers will inherit the kingdom of God. And these are all we are witnessing today in our society. And I pray to God to rescue us from this snares of Satan. But you too must stay clear. My father used to tell me, son, what you are not going to eat, don't smell it. Don't even snuff it, and don't even taste it. One time taste can lead to several avoidable giants in your life. Noah walked with God. Notice that the definition of walking with God is plainly included in the term. In contrast to the wickedness of man was great in the earth, and that every imagination of the thoughts of his heart was only evil continually. Noah was a just man and perfect in his generations. And Noah walked with God. Amen. So Noah found grace in the eyes of the Lord. Yes. Noah received grace because he obeyed the Lord.
Yes.
The Lord changed the name of Abram to Abraham with the command, I am the Almighty God. Walk before me. And be thou perfect. Abraham walked out of Babylon, where he was born, to a place where I will establish my covenant between me and thee by the grace of God Almighty. The salvation of the cross and the power of the Holy Spirit will walk you out of your Babylon today and walk you into your land of promise in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen.
Amen.
In Genesis 17, 1 to 7, and when Abraham was 90 years old and 9, the Lord appeared to Abraham and said unto him, I am the Almighty God, walk before me and be thou perfect. And I will make my covenant between me and thee, and will multiply thee exceedingly.
Yes.
And Abraham fell on his face, and God talked with him and saying, as for me, behold, my covenant is with thee, and thou shalt be a father of many nations.
Jesus.
Neither shall thy name any more be called Abraham, but thy name shall be called Abraham. For a father of many nations have I made thee.
Amen.
And I will make thee exceedingly fruitful. And I will make nations of thee, and kings shall come out of thee. And I will establish my covenant between me and thee, and thy seed after thee in their generations, for an everlasting covenant, to be a God unto thee, and to thy seed after thee. Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, who was later called Israel, all walk with God.
Yes.
As Jacob himself stated in Genesis 48, 15, and he blessed Joseph and said, God, before whom my fathers Abraham and Isaac did walk, the God which fed me all my life long unto this day. Please take note of this fact. An enemy can physically walk along with you. And that's usually when they are most dangerous. When they are close and they walk, it's actually a stalk. But only in obedience can one walk with God. God walks with those who walk with him.
Amen.
In Leviticus 26 verse 12, he said, And I will walk among you, and will be your God, and you shall be my people. Walking with God requires no interpretation. It's plainly stated for those who truly seek to walk with God. Deuteronomy 5:32 to 33 states, ye shall observe to do therefore, as the Lord your God hath commanded you. You shall not turn aside to the right or to the left. In verse 5, chapter 5, verse 33, you shall walk in all the ways which the Lord your God hath commanded you, that ye may live, and that it may be well with you, and that ye may prolong your days in the land which ye shall possess. The principle did not change with the New Testament era. The parents of John the Baptist were both righteous before God, walking in all the commandments and ordinances of the Lord, just as their son John did, as we also read in John 1, 6 to 8. And there was a man sent from God, whose name was John.
Yeah.
The same came for a witness, to bear witness of the light, that all men through him might believe. He was not that light, but was sent to bear witness of that light. And in Luke 1, 5 to 6, there was in the days of Herod, the king of Judea, a certain priest named Zacharias of the house of Abia, and his wife was of the daughters of Aaron, and her name was Elizabeth. And they were both righteous before God, walking in all the commandments and ordinances of the Lord, blameless. True Christianity is about walking with God, not walking with Satan, who is the god of this world, the prince of this world, who, just as he did to the first humans, had blinded the minds of them which believe not. In 2 Corinthians 4:2-6, he said, but have renounced the hidden things of dishonesty, not walking in craftiness, nor handling the word of God deceitfully, but by manifestation of the truth, commending ourselves to every man's conscience in the sight of God. But if our gospel be hid, it is hid to them that are lost, in whom the God of this world hath blinded the minds of them which believe not, lest the light of the glorious gospel of Christ, who is the image of God, should shine unto them. For we preach not ourselves, but Christ Jesus the Lord, and ourselves not your servants for Jesus' sake. For God, who commanded the light to shine out of darkness, has shined in our hearts to give the light of the knowledge of the glory of God in the face of Jesus Christ. Christians, walk the walk of truth. The commandments are simple if we are prepared to walk the walk of truth with God. The Bible said that true believers must worship God in spirit and in truth. And this brings us to the sermon this morning. Let us all open our Bible to Ephesians chapter 2. Can I please get our Bible, please? I want us to open to Ephesians chapter 2. And I'll be reading from verse 10 to 22. Are we there?
Amen.
Ephesians chapter 2. Apostle Paul explained it all. How we too became beneficiaries of that precious grace of the Almighty God. And he says, for we are his workmanship, created in Christ Jesus for good works, which God prepared beforehand, so that we will walk in them. Therefore, that formerly you, the Gentiles in the flesh, whom are caught on circumcision by the so-called circumcision, which is performed in the flesh by human hands, remember that you were at that time separated from Christ, excluded from the commonwealth of Israel, and the strangers to the covenants of promise,